Guys, my name is Abhijit and you're watching Code Keen. So in this video, we'll look like how you can add forget password functionality in your Django application, because a lot of time you have to just forget password, and this is a very important feature in your Django application or in any other application. You have to add a functionality of forget password. So in this video, we will look that. So before starting the video, if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe. I post Django related stuff and a lot of new videos are also coming, and a lot of video are also on the channel. You can definitely check those out, and let's start the video. So in this video, we will create a forget password functionality using email address, and what the project looks like. I will give you a demo. Like, we will hit a forget password and then we will enter our username. Like, my username for this project is Abhijit, and I will click Abhijit, submit, and eventually we will get the link to reset our password on the email which we have entered while registering ourselves on the website. And this is a link, this link looks like change password and a random string. So we will click the link and we can definitely change the password. Now my new password is ABC. So now my password is changed. So we will see this functionality in this video. So let me walk through the project. What I have done till now is, so for saving time, I have already prepared some things. I have already created views. Let me show you something. This is a login page, and this is a register page, and this is a forget password page. All the pages are being created just to save time. I don't want to see you watching all the writing HTML and other stuff. The video should be in a proper content, what is necessary for the video, what is necessary for you. So let's start. So first of all, let me tell you what project is all about. First, I have created a core project. The name of the project is core, and there is an app in the project. Its name is account, and I have already added the project in the settings.py, installed app accounts, and in views, I have already prepared how you can log in and how you register code. So let me walk through the code. So first of all, I have made a one-to-one relationship using profile model. The profile model is being one-to-one mapped with the user, one-to-one relationship. And there is a forget password token attribute in which we will store the token once the user clicks on forget password. And there is a created add field in that particular area. So again, come back to the project. It's login. First of all, we have a login HTML page, and we have already mentioned the Django messages, and we have already mentioned there is a form, and there is an input field of username, and there's an input field of login, a password. And for login, once you hit the submit button, the post request comes in the picture, and we just grab the username and password and just check if the user exists with that username. If it's not exist, then we actually redirect to the page showing the message user is not found, and redirect to the login page. After that, once the user we have found that user is there, then we authenticate using Django authenticate method, username equal to user and name and password is passed. If the username and the password are matches, so we have used Django authenticate function, which takes username and password as a parameter and checks is the password match with the current username, and if it matches, it returns the user object, and we are checking if the user object is none. That means authenticate is failed and it returned none. So we just redirect to the account login page and just say it's wrong password, and if the password is correct, we just type login and redirect. And in register picture, we have just if the request is post, and we are just grabbing the username, just in the case the indentation is quite wrong over here. Okay, let's let's see. So first of all, we are grabbing username, email and password, and just checking the username is already exists. If the username is already exists, we just redirect to the page, like username is already taken. And if the username email is already taken, just we again redirect to the page, like email is already taken. And once all these checks are done, we create a username by username and email and setting the password, and we again add profile object to the one-to-one relationship, and we are just saving the profile object and again redirect to the login page. So now let's move on to the picture. Let's again hope for the login forget password. What we will do is, once the user clicks on this forget password, we will check like if the username exists, and if that user already exists, then we will send an email to the person email, and where we will add a token, and that once the user click on that particular link, it will be redirected to the change password page. So let's again build that functionality. And if forget password, like if we first of all we will check if let's again open a try catch block, like always surround your code with try catch. Okay, so checking if the request dot method equal to post, then we will just grab the username, what the username is post dot get, and we will check if username, like we will just filter out the user. If user dot object dot filter username dot username dot first, if not, if it's none, like no user have been found, and again we will just redirect to the page, like no user is found, and let's copy something from here again. So let's paste it over here, like messages, and no user found, we will just no user found with this username. Okay, so we will, what's the page, like what the page is forget password, then again we will redirect to the forget password page. And if the user is found, we will just grab the email from that particular user, grab the email of the user, like user, first of all we will query the user obj, user obj is equal to user dot object dot get username is equal to username. Once we get the user object, we will get the email and send the email over get the email and send the email. So for sending email, like we have to create a function, and that function I would like to create in another file, like helpers.py, and we have to import like some things which are necessary for sending email. And we will first of all import from django.core.mail import send mail, and from again let's just create a function def send forget password underscore mail, and it will take like the email of the person. Okay, and for sending email, we will create a token, and for creating token we will use like import UUID. It generates a random string, so import UUID. okay, and the token will be like import UUID, and for UUID dot 4. Okay, so again it will just generate the token. Let me show you like what it will create. Python manage.py shell, and just paste it over here. And for printing, like we can use this one, just wait. So this is a string, like this is a unique string, and this will be act as a token for sending email. Okay, python manage.py run server, again like this is a token, and for sending email we have to create a subject. Subject is equal to your forget password link, and we have to create a message fstring. We will use fstring, Python fstring. Hi, click on the link to reset your password. Okay, so let's create a link. Like we will just copy the link from here, and the link is like change password. Okay, change password, and here it will be, there will be a token. So let's paste the link, and forget password, like it should be change password, and here it will be like token. So we will add the token here. Okay, so this is a link, and we have to use email underscore from. So for email we will be using like pasting the settings. These are the settings which you will get in the description section. We have to paste the settings in settings.py for the sending email, and here you have to add like your email and your password of Gmail. Okay, so let's go to the views, like where is the settings.py, models.py, helpers.py, and from email we have to import the settings from django.conf import settings, and we have to like paste the settings from, we have to import some settings from the settings.py. so we will use like settings.email host underscore user. So this is like this will be the email host user where you will put your email and the password. So email host user, then we have to like create a recipient list. And the list will be equal to email, and we have to call the function send mail. Send underscore mail, and the subject, we have to pass the subject, message, email underscore form, and the reception list, and we have to just return true. Okay, so I think you have got the what the idea is looking, and we have to call the function in our views.py. for this we have to import the dot and import this function, so form dot helpers from dot helpers import this one, and we have to just copy this function below here. So user obj is equal to user obj, and we have to just, I think we have to generate the token over here, because we have to save this token, this particular token, in the models.py in profile section user forget password token. So we will, the helper function which we have created, it will take two arguments, like first one will be at email and another one will be a token. So for token we can just copy this thing and paste it over here for generating token, and we can, again we have to import the UUID from here. Okay, so we can just paste it over here for now, and we can remove this token from here. So I think you are getting what I'm doing, like the function takes now takes two parameters. First one will be an email and another one will be a token, and that token will be appended over here. So again going to the views.py, we have generated a token, we have passed the token, and we again have to just send over here. Okay, so an email is sent. Okay, so again let's go to the change password section. It will take a token, and from that token we have to get the profile instance. So from model, from URLs, this one take will be token, and in views we have to get try accept exception as e print e. Again we have to create a context variable, this one, and we have to query profile obj, profile underscore obj is equal to profile dot object dot get, and we have to get by the forget password token, so equal to token. Once we get this one, we can have to print the profile obj. So let's test what we have wrote till now, then again we will check what's going on. Okay, so let's again go to the login page and click on forget password, and we have to enter the username, and I think something like we haven't copied this one. Okay, so let's go to the forget password page, and I think it's already done. We have to add it over here, like CSRF token and all those stuff. So like CSRF token, okay, and the method will be equal to post. Okay, name, username, like submit. Let's hit on submit and enter our username. My username is Abhijit, and so an email is sent, and we have got an email. So I click on the link to reset your password. So as you can see, if we will click on the link, that will go to the this one page, and we are printing the profile object over here. Okay, so let's click. So profile matching query does not exist, dot object dot filter and dot first. Okay, so let's again reload the page, and the query set is none. And how is this even possible? We have done something wrong over here. We haven't saved that profile, that token in the profile instance. So we have to save that token in the profile instance, and we can grab it over profile obj is equal to profile dot object dot get user is equal to user obj, and in the profile obj we have to set the token, hai na? So for saving the token we will profile obj dot save password token, forget password token, and that token will be the token which we have created right now. So and we have to again save that profile obj. So again I think it will work now, and again just click on Abhijit, and again send the, and we have again received an email. So as you can see now, we have to click on this one, and you can see we have got the object, and now we have to pass the user ID over here in the using context variable, and we can add context of user underscore ID is equal to profile obj dot user dot ID, and we have to settle out this user ID in forget change password page. So let's add it over here, below here, input type will be hidden, and the name will be user ID, and the value will be the user ID which we have got from the backend. Let me show you something. Like, we can go to the change password page. Okay, so let me show you form. We haven't passed the context, so for passing we have to pass the context over here. Okay, so again reload the page. So if you can see, we have got the user value is equal to 2. So now what we will do is we will check if request dot method equal to post, then we will like grab the confirm new password and confirm password, new confirm new password equal to request dot post dot new password, and for confirm password, and we will also get the user ID. So user ID is equal to request dot post dot user ID. So if user underscore ID is none, we have to redirect to the page. Like, we haven't found the user ID. The user ID is none. We can just user ID found, and we have to return redirect change hyphen password and the token which we have got. Okay, token. Otherwise we will just get the user or instance. User obj is equal to user dot objects dot get id is equal to user id, and again let's just check if, like, we have to again check the new password and confirm password are same or not. If both are same, new password is not equal to confirm password, then again we have to redirect to that particular page, like saying both are not equal. Okay, both should be equal, and if all the checks are performed, we have to get the user obj request dot user dot get and user obj dot password is equal to user obj dot set password, and we have to save the user obj dot save, and we again have to redirect to the login page. Okay, so I think you people are getting the idea what I have done. So if the request is post, we are getting the new password, confirm password, and the user ID which we have passed to the context. And if in case like user ID is not found, we again redirect to the page, like no user ID found, and we are again checking if the new password and confirm password are both are not equal, we again are returning back to that page, both should be equal, and if all the checks are performed, we are getting the user instance and saving the password, like hashing the password through set password method and saving to the object and redirecting to the login page. Okay, so if the request dot post dot, we can context over here again, we have to like context should be over here, and we can copy the context. Okay, so I think now it's good to go, and again let's change the password. I'm writing 1234 1234, again we have done something wrong over here, like we haven't added method post and CSRF token. Okay, so method will be like post, and we have to add the CSRF token, CSRF underscore token. Okay, so now we are good to go. Let's again reload the page, remove all the things from here, and again click the link. Okay, so just change the password 1234, and let's again do something wrong over here. Both should be equal. Now it's working 1234. I think we have again done something wrong. Reconfirm password and new password. So we have to get these thing like reconfirm password. Okay, so 1 2 3 1 2 3 login, and again I'm writing the old password. It's showing the wrong password, and if we write the password which we have changed right now, we can do it's login. Now we are logging to the page and we can again log out. So this is it for the video. I hope you will you have enjoyed the video, and if you have any doubt, you can follow me on Instagram and drop a message over here, over there, or you can subscribe and mention your comments, like whatever you are getting. I will try to solve as soon as possible. So if you like my content, please subscribe, and meet you in the next video. Goodbye.